the way to find product market fit, right? It's really something that I can say, but I think when you do it, it's much more than just saying it. It's actually about talking to your users and making sure that you are very close to them. I'm here to actually do this with you, and also most importantly, I'm here to actually listen to you and work on this mission together. If you want to solve a problem, right, you have to solve it with your heart. Like, this is something that I really do. Like, you have to be very sincere about solving it. You know, I started being sincere about solving people's problems. And 10 years down the road, 20 years down the road, I'm still going to be that person who is like day one, I'm still going to be sincere about solving it. They are not my users, they are our champions of the nation. And I think that's how important it is to actually think about finding product market fit, is that you really have to get down to the ground and really be sincere and say, cannot have that, you know, you can't have that capitalist mindset and say, I'm here to make money out of product. Money will come. Money will come if you are sincere about solving people's problems.
How did it pivot, right, to the past 6 months or so?
Yeah. You know, today we have achieved like incredible, you know, market fit and growth. I think that people talk about us, people love us. We have an extremely high NPS score of 86. You know, people just absolutely love like being a part of this community. Now, I think the way to find product market fit, right, it's really something that I can say, but I think when you do it, it's much more than just saying it. It's actually about talking to your users and making sure that you are very close with them. Now, believe it or not, I think Eric, you because you probably would have experienced this as a mentor. When you first join as a mentor, when anyone first get accepted as a mentor, I would actually personally send all of you a LinkedIn message and let you know that you have been accepted, right? And so I don't do that just for you, Eric. I do that for every single mentor that has been accepted on ADPList. Or at least I try to do that for every single one. I'm pretty sure I cover like 98% of people. And the reason why I do that is because I want them to know that I'm here to actually do this with you. And also most importantly, I'm here to actually listen to you and work on this mission together. Because to me, mentors and mentees are not a user of the platform. I never call them a user. Like, I also let my team know that we will never call these people users. Like, we call them our partners. We call them like our mentors. We call them like our friends. Right, because the one reason is this is because they are on this mission with us, right? They are on this mission with us. They are not like here just to be like part of Facebook or whatever, right? They are on this mission with us. Like, we don't want to be the next like company that is just like, oh, just grow users and users. We want to grow champions. We want to grow and make sure that people believe in this thing that we're fundamentally doing. So I connect with all the mentors. And on the mentee side, I actually send everyone an email as well, right? And when someone, I'll send them an email and say, hey, this is my personal email. If you have any issues, you can come directly to me. And obviously, I think I'm creating more, you know, like more emails for myself, right? Every morning I wake up to a lot of emails, but that's fine, right? That's fine. That's fine by me. I take about an hour or so to clear those emails, to reply some of them, and to really understand where they're coming from, right? And ask them questions as well. I think as a founder, like maybe a very experienced founder would hire someone else to do that for them. Right? Like those people that has like second time, third time founder, or like they are already like, you know, well off or something, they'll do that and they'll do this for them. But I will never do that. I will never ever do that, because if you want to solve a problem, right, you have to solve it with your heart. Like, this is something that I really do. Right? You have to be very sincere about solving it. You know, I started being sincere about solving people's problems. And 10 years down the road, 20 years down the road, I'm still going to be that person who is like day one, I'm still going to be sincere about solving it. They are not my users. They are our champions of the nation. And I think that's how important it is to actually think about finding product market fit, is that you really have to get down to the ground and really be sincere and say, cannot have that, you know, you can't have that capitalist mindset and say, I'm here to make money out of you. Money will come. Money will come if you are sincere about solving people's problems. Right? And I'm not concerned about that. I mean, there are investors who ask me like, hey, you know, monetization model and stuff like that. But I always push back and I say, I want to solve the people's problems. We can talk about that maybe 2 years, 3 years.